All right, let's bullshit. Cheers to the release of our new movie. So, first off, that's what we're here to do. We're here to bullshit about our movie, A Long Strange Trip, which premiered on the 7th of this month, October 2021.
Yeah.
And basically, it's like a pretty cute little movie, right?
Yeah.
Right. So we want to basically talk about where this started, where like the seeds of the story originated, and where it kind of went from there, and how it grew, and how it became better. The more people that got involved, you know, it's because that's how it works when you make these sort of things, you know.
Yeah.
You get some creative people in the mix, and everyone's gonna have a little idea that makes it that much better.
Yeah.
So we just want to talk about our process, particularly for this movie. But we might end up getting on a tangent about our music videos that we've been making for my songs as well. So anyway, I'm gonna hand it over to Jeremy here. Let's where did this song, or this movie, which I gave away a clue. So the song that started the idea for this movie.
Mad River, and my friend showed it to me and I was like, man, that should be a movie. And I like tried to write Rob Zombie then make it, and I was like, man, I guess he's never gonna do that. Never got the letter.
He was just busy, yeah. Yeah, he was just busy. He would have gotten back to you, but...
I was like, man, I'd like to make that movie someday. Then, finally, like November of last year...
I think you gotta push your voice over the mariachi right now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, project.
I wonder if we should check it out.
All right. So, we moved, if you can tell. So let's get back to it.
Last year, I was like, you asked me if I was ever gonna like do anything like with videos, or if I wanted to do anything. I was like, I don't want to make the movie about that story. And you're like, oh yeah, that'd be cool.
Mad River, for all of you non-old hippies, is a band from like the 60s?
68.
Like a folk, psychedelic rock with hard country rock. And hard rock. They're pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, Jeremy has introduced me to them.
I got the idea from the song.
The song called The War Goes On.
Yeah, I was like, maybe someday if I could get everything together, maybe I could make it. That was back when, like, video cameras were more expensive and they weren't
2009.
So, yeah.
Ish.
And they weren't on phones so great, so I was like, man, I'll have to buy some expensive camera or something to do that. But ended up using mostly iPhone 7 Plus to film it.
Please sponsor us. iPhone 7 Plus.
Yeah. And I was like, that'd be cool to like help inspire maybe the people to make their own films, and like,
yeah,
if we could do it, they could do it.
Yeah, yeah.
I was like,
that's kind of our little credo.
Yeah.
When we're making films, we're like, we hope people will see how stupid, ugly, and poor that we are, and be like, man, I don't have any excuse not to make a fucking movie. Look at these jackasses. It's true though. That is like our mantra. We're like, stupid, ugly, poor.
Nah.
But destined for more.
Jeez.
Ugh. Dark chocolate. 92%. That's disgusting. Anyway. As we were saying, we're stupid, we're ugly, we're poor. And we did this.
Yeah.
Okay. I probably shouldn't say shit like that, but for real. It's really easy to doubt yourself and to make excuses to not make, to not pursue, whatever it is.
Follow your dreams.
Exactly. There's something creative in most of us. I mean, I can't say all of us, but like, so many people would love to say that they made a movie.
Yeah.
And yeah, this took a lot of work and everything.
Yeah.
But it didn't take all the resources we thought we needed to do it, or would have used as an excuse to not make it, you know? So I'm glad that just like, you asked me, you said, will you play the girl in the story that gets, whatever, I don't want to spoil the movie. Of course, if you're watching this, you probably have seen the movie, I'm guessing. Yeah. But like, you asked me to play her, and of course, you know, I was like,
yeah.
You flatter me. And I was stoked because I'm always organizing my own videos and asking people to be in my shit. So it was just nice to be asked to be in someone else's production. I kind of was like, well, how much of this story do you got? You know, could I maybe, could I help you write it? Because you got the bones of it.
Yeah.
But like, maybe we could make this a full production.
Yeah.
That would be amazing.
Full, like, partnership of the film.
Right. Like, let's come together. I'll use my interest in character development and dialogue, you know, all my writing skills that I'm trying to hone. And then you can have, you know, the certain musical things, because Jeremy's super into music. He's probably more into music than I am. And he's definitely more into movies and stuff, but like, you had certain songs that ended up being brilliant additions to the movie, so. We just like let each other play to our strengths. But then like, we cross over, we see what the other person's doing, and we still are able to be like, well, hey, what about we do something like that? Or hey, I like what you're doing over here, but like, can we maybe think about adding this specific camera angle, this specific line?
Yeah.
You know, I would throw some dialogue in there, and then you would be like, well, okay, well, we have to make this line. We have to say Kyle Gass famous, because Kyle Gass from Tenacious D signed his top hat. So you're beholden to him. So I think that's like, I think the whole point of this video really is to talk about how, you know, two heads are better than one.
Yeah.
It's played out or whatever. Like, if both of us were given this assignment, like where these are your characters and here's the general flow of events, neither one of us would have made as good a story.
I'd come up with an idea, and then she'd come up with the idea, and we'd just like, kind of like putting bricks down the build.
Right.
The house or the movie.
Kind of like having a kid.
Yeah.
You know, if it was just my genetic matter, then it wouldn't even be a kid. It would just be a... an egg and a uterus. it needs
two.
Yeah.
Tango.
You know, one person could write a whole movie.
Yeah.
One person could come up with all the characters and. Cheers.
Let it.
Beautiful. One person could make. A story up, of course. People do it all the time, like bad fan fiction on the internet and stuff. Like, people come up with stories all the time. But there's just something special about like two people with a similar goal.
That have picked up different things in their life.
Yeah.
They could add things that the other one wouldn't have added.
Between like our different interests, it just brought out a more rounded out, complete story.
Yeah.
We're like fucking proud of ourselves. We really are. And we know it's fucking low budget and cheesy as shit.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's not something it's not. We know that.
Yeah.
We don't think like, okay, next stop Hollywood.
Yeah.
And we don't really want that either.
Yeah. Just want to be KG famous.
We just want to be Kyle Gass famous. We were chatting with a friend earlier, and he had seen the movie. His favorite scene was the dog, so I mean, I guess that really had nothing to do with Jeremy or I, but he had said...
A talented dog.
Oh, fucking, he blew us all out of the water, like, embarrassing. But he was saying how Quentin Tarantino, who I've not watched a lot of his films, but, you know, Quentin Tarantino will spend all this money making a movie with expensive equipment and top-tier actors. I don't know why I quoted that, but you know what I mean. Like, I'm not paying attention to that shit. But they're rich. They're famous. They're A-listers, I suppose you would say. And he spends all his money, but then he'll make a movie that's supposed to look like it was made on shitty old equipment. And I'm not knocking him. I guess if I had a lot of money, I would still be trying to make something that looked kind of old and, like, you know, kind of have that nostalgic flair to it. So even if we could afford the equipment, it would probably look similar to what we did with this. I'm disgusting. I'm just, like, licking chocolate off my fingers. Probably should cut that out. Anyways. But the fact that it was, like, low budget, because that's kind of, I think, one of the little talking points when we talk about the movie with people that have seen it, they'll be like, well, yeah, the fact that it was low budget didn't really detract from my enjoyment of it. And
yeah, it was
right,
really low budget. It's like
super low budget.
Yeah,
we cut a payphone off of a phone booth and then glued it. Taped it into another phone booth.
Oh, just stuck it in the hole.
Whatever.
It kind of just stayed.
It just kind of stayed, but... Like, we went up one night, all fucking James Bond, and we're like, the wire cutters.
And the phone was destroyed.
Oh, yeah, previously. No, this was not functional.
It was not working.
We would not have taken... I can't say that we wouldn't have. We were really desperate for a payphone.
The earpiece was missing.
It had been long out of commission.
And I think I remember the guy beating it, like, years ago.
And he remembers a tweaker.
Just, like, pounding it on
the pounding it.
And I'm like, it's oh, that's crazy.
So, you know, the phone booth that we purloined the phone from had long been
out of service.
And, you know, I guess this is where we say don't try this at home, kids. But we rolled up one night with the wire cutters and we're like, all right, come on. And we probably should have had me be the fucking one running because I'm a little faster than you and you could have been the getaway car driver. But we did it how we did it and we got away with it too.
Yeah.
And so, like, we're incriminating ourselves.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's cool. It's fine. So basically, you know, there's that where you have to be resourceful.
Oh, yeah.
Like, if you're going low budget, you really have to just, like, want it.
Because like,
if you really want it, you're going to go for it.
See-through wrapping paper over a flashlight to make some of the coloring in the van and a little bit in the truck, the diesel.
Right.
And
you were really set on the blue and red.
Yeah.
In those last scenes where she gets her revenge.
Like a tribute to the creep show.
Nah, he had a lot of references. I had no idea what they were. But when you see someone just, like, so set on a detail to pay homage to their heroes, you go with it. You're like, okay, yeah, we're doing that.
Yeah.
Don't fucking bite my head off. We'll do that. Yeah, he's pretty, like, you wouldn't believe what a malicious, what a violent. No, Jeremy's, you know, he's a gentle dude.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, we have to be really resourceful. But it really is like that thing where they say, you know, if you have a will, if there's a will, there's a way. And, you know, we were making posts on Facebook, which of course YouTube, free fucking downloads for sound effects and things, like, makes our job so much easier. But I made a post because our original villain that was going to play David Chappendonk, kind of fell off. We were like, oh, okay, are you just going to not get back to us? Like, okay, well, fuck it. I don't care. So I made a post and I said, like, okay, we need a villain and he needs to drive a truck, like a semi truck. And then, like, friends were sharing it, and then through the friends sharing it, I saw their friends commenting on the post, and they're like, hey, call Howard Miller Trucking in Marysville. And so, like, one day, even though it sucks to, like, pick up a phone and be like, hey, so, like, I'm a filmmaker, do you have, like, a employee who could play, like, a villain or something? But he did. Fortunately, the owner was like, yeah, dude, tell me when the movie's out. I got the perfect guy. He's got, like, this mean-looking truck, and he's got face tats. I'll give him your number. And that was, like, that was that. Like, we had our villain. So, you know, you gotta, I guess, kind of the whole point of that story is, like, you gotta push yourself outside of your little bubble. It might suck to have to make phone calls to random trucking companies with stupid requests.
The house in the beginning of the movie, I didn't even know who they were. I just saw that they had a cool house and walked up and said, hey, could I have my nephews walk out of your house for this scene in a movie? And they're like, oh, sure, okay, yeah. And they, like, helped set up some, like, Halloween decorations. And they're like, okay, you're ready when we're ready when you are. And
yeah.
That's pretty crazy. They just let us into their house, and you just have to ask.
You just gotta ask, because, like, it's kind of like, you know, a sad dude at the bar who's just trying to hit on everything that walks by. They don't got anything to lose.
Yeah.
Just, you know, it's like that.
Yeah.
That's how we are, like, basically, in filmmaking.
Yeah.
And that's a terrible analogy. I've been coming up with really gross analogies. Like an unfertilized egg. It's like a horny old drunk man.
That's funny.
But it's true, you know? Like, and the cool thing is, like, a lot of people, they want to be part of something cool, you know? Yeah. When you're excited about something, it's not hard for people to see that and be like, okay, well, I want to know more. Okay, well, that's cool. Like, I would like to be a part of that. Like, if you have some sort of artistic thing, like, don't be afraid to ask people for help. Yeah. It doesn't mean everyone wants to do everything for free.
Yeah.
We've been lucky that people have taken, for better lack of better word, pity upon the fact that we really were going into this with, like, no budget whatsoever.
Yeah.
You get lucky sometimes. Yeah. But sometimes, you know, you're trying to ask an artist who's been playing an instrument or acting for however many years, and you know, you're like, okay, well, I'll pay you something. I know it's not what you're worth or whatever, if you have to assign a dollar amount of value to somebody's art, which is not fun. It's not, doesn't feel right, you know, but yeah, we got really lucky in this particular case.
Yeah.
Going forward, having a budget.
That'd be cool.
Oh yeah, no doubt. That would be great.
Yeah.
But we all start somewhere. You can't let the fact that you are ugly or stupid or poor stop you from creating, from dreaming.
Yeah.
You know, so. Cheers, bud.
Quack.
Quack.